decked out for the funeral parlor. Look at you. I don't even think you bumped your head.
It was the car's fault.
Mama, the car did not roll down the driveway and over the Pollard's garage all by itself. You had it in the wrong gear.
I did not.
You had it in reverse instead of drive. The police report shows that.
Well, you should have let me keep my LaSalle.
Your LaSalle was 8 years old.
I don't care. It never would have behaved this way, and you know it.
Mama, cars do not behave. They are behaved upon. The fact is, you, all by yourself, destroyed that packet.
Think what you want. I know the truth.
The truth. The truth is you shouldn't be allowed to drive a car anymore.
No!
Mama, we're going to hire somebody to drive you.
No, we are not. This is my business.
Mama, your insurance policy was written, so they're going to have to give you a brand new car.
Not another packet, I hope.
Lord Almighty, don't you understand what I'm even trying to say to you?
Quit talking so ugly to your mother.
Mama, you are a 72-year-old woman. $2,700. You're a terrible risk. No one's going to insure you ever.
You're just saying that to be hateful.
Well, you're right. I'm making it all up. Every insurance company in America is out in our driveway right now, waving their fountain pens and falling all over themselves to get you to sign up. Everybody wants Daisy Wortham, the only woman in the history of driving, to demolish a 3-week-old packet, a 2-car garage, and the freestanding tool shed in one fell swoop.
You talk so foolish sometimes, Foolie.
Even if you could get a policy somewhere, it wouldn't be safe. I'd worry all the time. Now look at how many of your friends have men that drive them, huh? Miss Ethel has, Miss Ida Jacobs, and Noni.
Well, they're all rich.
Daddy left you plenty enough for this. Now, I'm going to do the interviewing at the plant. Oscar, in the freight elevator, well, he knows every colored man in Atlanta worth talking about. So I'm sure in 2 weeks' time I can find you somebody perfect.
No!
Mama, you won't even have to
do
anything.
I said no. Now stop running your mouth. I am 72 years old. And you're so gallant that it's going to happen. And I am a widow. But unless they rewrote the Constitution and didn't tell me about it, I still have rights. And one of the rights I have is the right to invite who I want, not who you want, into my house. You do accept the fact that this is my house? And what I do not want and absolutely will not have is some chauffeur sitting in my kitchen, gobbling my food, running up my phone bill. Oh, I hate all that in my house.
You have Idella?
Idella is different. She's been coming to me 3 times a week since you were in 8th grade. We know how to stay out of each other's way. And even still, there are nicks and chips in most of my wedding china, and I have seen her throw a silver fork into the garbage pail more than once.
Mama, are you trying to tell me Ben Idella has some kind of vendetta against your silverware?
Stop being sassy. You know what I mean. I was brought up to do for myself. On Forsyth Street, we couldn't afford them, and so we did for ourselves. That's still the best way, if you ask me.
Them, huh? You sound like Governor Talmadge.
What good? What a thing to say. I am not prejudiced. Aren't you ashamed?
I gotta be going in. Maureen will be having a fit.
Y'all must have plans tonight.
Going to the Ansleys for a dinner party.
I see.
You see what, Mama?
The Ansleys. I'm sure Florine bought herself another new dress. This is her idea of heaven on earth, isn't it?
What?
Socializing with Episcopalian.
Yes, Aunt Noni can take you anywhere you need to go for the time being.
I'll be fine.
Well, fine. I'll call first. And I still intend to interview colored men.
No!
Mama!
After the ball is over. After the spray.
Send him on in. Yes, Oak, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Oak Cooper.
Have a seat there. I just need to finish signing some papers.
Go right ahead.
Don't want Ms. McClatchy fussing at me.
Go right ahead. Got all the time in the world.
I see. So how long have you been out of work?
Since back before last November.
Long time.
Well, Mr. Worthington, you try to be mean looking for work. They're hiring colored, they're hiring young. So they ain't even hiring much young since like. Mr. Worthington, you people are Jewish, ain't you?
Why, yes, we are. Why do you ask?
I'd rather drive for Jews. The people always say that it's cheap and stingy, but don't say nothing around me.
Good to know you feel that way. Now, tell me, where did you work before?
That's what I was going to ask. One time we were working for this lady at Little Five Points. What was her name? I forget. Anyway, she's the president of the Ladies Auxiliary over yonder, the pause of the Baptist Church. And she always going about God and Jesus and doing to others. You know what I'm talking about?
I'm not sure. Go on.
Well, one day, Mr. Worthy, she told me, Hope, come on back in the back with me. I got something for you. So we went back yonder, and Lord have mercy, she had all these old shirts and colors all over the bed. Nasty, yellow, you know, like they'd been stuck in the shiver road and forgot about it. And she said, ain't they nice? They belong to my daddy before he passed. And we fixed them and sell them to you for 25 cents a piece.
Now, what was her name?
What was that woman's name? Anyway. As I was telling you, any fool sees a bunch of old shirts and colors like that, no, ain't worth a nickel. Them's to call the people the Jews cheap. I told her, yes, sir, I'll think about it. And I got myself another job as fast as I can.
And where was that?
Harold Stone, Jewish gentleman just like you. Live over the Little Water Road.
I knew Judge Stone.
You don't say. You don't give me this shoe, really don't finish with it, this necktie too.
Now you drove for Judge Stone?
7 years to the day near about. That will still be working for him if he didn't die. Now Mrs. Stone closed up the house and moved to her people to Savannah. And she said, come on down to Savannah with us, Hope. Because my wife's dead at the time. But I said, no, thank you. I didn't want to leave my grandbabies behind. And I don't get along with that teacher trash you got down there.
Judge Stone was a good friend of my father's.
You don't say. Well, Oscar said I'd be driving for your family. What'd I be doing? Be driving your kids to school, your wife to the beauty parlor, something like that?
No, I don't have any children.
That's a shame. My daughter, best thing ever happened to me. But you're young yet. I won't worry now.
I won't. Thank you. Now, did you drive for anybody after Judge Stone?
I drove the milk truck for the Avenue Dairy through the whole war, the one just was.
Hope, what I'm looking for is someone who can drive my mother around.
Excuse me for asking. How come she ain't hired for herself?
Well, it's a delicate situation.
Oh, she done gone around the bend a little. Nice way. Nothing to get on.
No, nothing like that. She's all there. She's too much there. That's the problem. It just isn't safe for her to drive anymore. Now, she knows it, but she'll never admit it. I'll be frank with you. I'm a little desperate.
I know about that. One time I was out of work and my wife said to me, oh, Hope, you ain't gonna get none other job. I said, what you talking about, woman? And the very next week I go work for that woman at Little Five Point. Cahill, Francis Cahill. And then I go work for Judge Stone, and then the reason I'm happy to hear y'all Jews.
Hope, I need you to understand something though. My mother is a little high strung. She doesn't want anybody driving. So the fact is, you'll be working for me. Now, she can say anything she wants to, but she can't fire you. You understand?
Oh, sure I do. Don't worry none about that. I'll hold on whatever way she run me. When I was nothing but a little boy on the farm of Macon, I used to wrestle hogs into the ground at killing time. And ain't no hog got away from me yet.
All right. How's $20 a week, son?
Sounds like you got your mama chauffeur. I see that.
My husband taught me how to run a car.
Yes, sir.
I remember everything he told me. So don't you think for one moment that you can... Wait. You're speeding. I can see it.
I ain't going but 90 miles an hour.
I like to go under the speed limit.
Speed limit 35 here.
The slower you go, the more you save on gas, my husband.
We barely move. We might as well walk the thing a bit.
Is this your car?
No.
Do you buy the gas?
No.
All right then. My fine son may think I'm losing my abilities, but I am in control of what goes on in my car. Where are you going?
To the grocery store.
Then why didn't you turn on Highland Avenue?
Piggly Wiggly ain't on Highway Avenue. It's on Euclid, down there near.
I know where it is, and I want to go the way I've always gone, on the Highland Avenue.
But that's 3 blocks out of the way, Miss Daisy.
Go back this minute.
With the wrong lane, I can't just...
Well, if you don't go back, I'm going to get out of this car.
Oh, but okay, you can get out the door.
Oh, this is wrong. Where are you taking me?
The store.
I want to go back to Highland Avenue. Mm-hmm. I have been driving to the Piggly Wiggly since they put it up and opened it for business. This isn't the way. Go back this minute.
Y'all know the Piggly Wiggly?
Get ready to turn now. Watch out, there's a little boy behind the shopping cart.
I see that.
Pull in next to the blue car.
We close her right here by the door.
Next to the blue car?
Yes.
I don't park in the sun. It fades the upholstery.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Give me the key. And you stay right here by the car.
Yes.
And you don't have to go tell everybody my business.
No. Don't forget the Dutch cleanser now. And now you're doing what? What's so terrible in that?
You. You don't understand me. Why do I talk to you?
No, I don't. I truly don't. Because if I ever got a hold of what you got, I'll be shaking it around for everybody in the world to see.
That's vulgar. Don't talk to me. What did you say? I heard that.
Miss Daisy, you need a chauffeur. And Lord knows, I need a job. Let's just leave it at that.
Standing here in one piece.
I wanted you to be here when he comes. I wanted you to hear what he has to say.
Hear what? Mama, what is going on?
He is stealing from me.
Hope, are you sure?
I don't make empty accusations. I have proof.
What proof?
This. I caught him red-handed. I found this hidden in the garbage pail under some coffee grounds.
You mean he stole a can of salmon?
Well, here it is. Oh, I knew that something was funny. They all take things, you know. So I counted.
You counted?
Well, first the silverware and the linen dinner napkin. And then I went into the pantry. I turned on the light, and the first thing that caught my eye was a hole right behind the corned beef. And I knew it right away. I had only 8 cans of salmon, but I had 9.3 for a dollar on salmon.
Very clever, Mama. You made me miss my breakfast and be late to a meeting at the bank over a 33-cent can of salmon? Here. You want 33 cents? Here. Here's a dollar. Here's $10. Buy yourself a whole pantry full of salmon, Mama.
Why, truly. Yeah, I did. They were looking at me like, I don't want your money, I want my things.
Mama, one can of salmon.
It was mine. I bought it and I put it there, and he went in the pantry and he took it and he never said a word. I leave him plenty of food every day and I always tell him exactly what it is. Oh, they are like having little children in the house. They want something, so they just take it. Not a smidgen of conscience, no manners. Oh, he'll never admit this. No, he said. I don't know nothing about her. And I don't like this. I don't like living this way. I have no privacy.
Mama.
Oh, go ahead, Ben. You always do.
All right. I give up. You want to drive yourself again? You just arrange it with the insurance company, Mama. Take your blessed trolley, buy yourself a taxi cab, whatever you want, Mama. But this time you're going to leave me out of it.
Oh, hey.
Morning, Miss Daisy. I believe the fix is to clear up today. Oh, excuse me, Mr. Worthing. I didn't know we were here.
Oak, I think we need to have a talk.
Sure, give me a moment. I'll put my coat away. I'll be right with you. Oh, Miss Daisy, yesterday when you were out eating with your sister, I ate a can of your salmon. I know you told me to eat leftover pork chops, but they stay. So I don't buy another can. Do you want me to put it in the pantry for you?
Yes. Thank you, both.
I'll be right with you, Miss.
I have to get dressed.
Yeah.
digging, Miss Daisy. We've been here to the cemetery 3 times this month already, and ain't even a 20th yet.
Oh, it's good to come out in the nice weather.
Yes, sir. Mrs. Ace Ray, mighty well attended. I believe you're the best widow in the state of Georgia.
Bowley's always pestered me to have the staff out here tend to the plot. Perpetual care, I think they call it.
Don't you do it. It's right to have somebody from the family looking after you.
Well, I'll certainly never have that. Bowley'll have me in perpetual care before I'm cold.
Miss Daisy.
Oh, take those flowers and set them on Leo Bowers' grave.
Is Rose Bowers' husband?
That's right. She asked me to bring them out here for her. She's not very good about coming, and I believe that today would have been Leo's birthday.
Yes, sir. Where did that?
I'm not exactly sure, but I know it's over that way on the other side of the weeping cherry. Look for the headstone, Bower. What's the matter?
Nothing the matter. Miss Daisy?
I told you it's over that way behind the weeping cherry. Look, the headstone says Bower.
How'd that look?
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about I can't read.
What?
I can't read.
Well, that's ridiculous. Anybody can read.
No, not me.
You know, then why do I see you, reading the paper every day?
That's just what I'm doing. I'm just reading the paper, reading what was happening from the pictures.
You know your letters, don't you?
My ABCs? Yeah, pretty good. I just can't read.
Stop saying that. You're making me mad. If you know your letters, then you can read. I taught some of the stupidest children. The name is Bower. 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 What does a B letter sound like?
Like a B?
Of course. Bower. B. Bower. Bower. What letter sounds like
Sounds like an R.
So the first letter is a
B.
And the last letter is a
R.
Bower. 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 It even sounds like Bower, doesn't it?
Sure does, Miss Daisy. That's it.
That's it. Now you go on over there like I told you in the first place, and you look for a headstone that has a B at the beginning and an R at the end, and that'll be Bower.
We ain't gonna where we're coming in the middle?
Not right now. That'll be enough for you to find it. Go on now.
Yes, sir.
And don't you come back here telling me you can't do it because you can.
Miss Daisy?
What is it now?
I appreciate this.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I didn't do anything. Go on now. Please hurry up. I'm burning up out here.
Yes.
Hello, Mama. Merry Christmas. Hey, listen, would you do Florine a favor, huh? She's having a fit and the grocery store's closed today. You got any coconut up in your pantry? You do? Would you bring it with you when you come? All right, hang on. Hey, Mom, honey, your ambrosia's saved. Mama's got the coconut. Many thanks, Mama, okay? I'll see you in on, all right? Oh, hey, Mama. Ho, ho, ho.
Everybody's giving the Georgia Power and Light Company a Merry Christmas.
Marie got them beat with them lights.
She makes an ass out of herself every year. She always has to go and put a wreath in every window. And that silly Santa Claus winking on the front door.
I bet you got the biggest tree. We should get him so large.
It's absurd. If I had a nose like Floree, I wouldn't go around saying Merry Christmas to anybody.
I like Christmas at them house.
I don't wonder. You're the only Christian in the place.
Except they got the new cook.
Oh, Floree never could keep help. Of course, it's none of my business.
No.
Too much running around. The garden club this and the junior league that, as if any one of them would ever give her the time of day. But she'd die before she'd make a glass of iced tea for the temple sisterhood.
Yes, sir, you're right.
I just hope she doesn't take it in her head to sing this year.
You don't say a mouthful, Miss Daisy.
You know, you didn't have to come home. Bully would have run me out.
I know that.
Then why did you?
Not my business, Miss Daisy. Oh, look at that. Florine got put the Rudolph reindeer in the dogwood tree.
Oh, if her grandfather Frytek could see this. What is it you say? He'd jump out of his grave and he'd snatch her bald head. Now wait a minute. This isn't a Christmas present.
No.
You know, I don't give Christmas presents.
Yes, you do.
I just happened to come across this morning and opened it up.
Oh. Ain't nobody ever gave me a book. Hat, written, copy, grade 5.
I used to teach out of this. I saved a few.
Yes, sir.
It's faded, but it works. If you practice, you'll write nicely.
Yes, sir.
But you have to practice. I taught Mayor Hosfield out of this same book.
Thank you, Miss Daisy.
It isn't a Christmas present.
No.
Jews don't have any business giving Christmas presents. And you don't have to go yapping about this to Bully and Florine.
This is strictly between me and you, Miss Daisy.
The red nose reindeer.
Oh, they've seen us. I don't want to turn off the high five.
I hope I don't spit up.
All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor
Come on, Hope, get a wiggle on. You gotta see off and let him through.
Just empty the trash. What's that in the garbage station?
Now, where is his mom?
She's back in the room. She can't go on without her. I really think she's thinking all about this.
It's crazy. The car's a car.
You watch over this machine like a chicken hawk. One time we were parked in front of the drive thru over yonder the plaza, and this white man looked kind of a banker, a lawyer, dressed up real fine. Uh-huh. He done put his satchel on our trunk while he opened up his trunk. Lord, money. Why he did that for? Your mama jumped out the back door and run this man every which way.
Hey, Mama tell you the new car's gonna have air conditioning.
Oh, she don't like no air cool. Says you do the negging.
You smoking.
You know how Mama fought me, but it's time for a trade. She's losing equity on this car. I bet the two of you are gonna miss this old thing.
Mm-mm, not me.
Well, now, come on, you're the only one that's driven it all this time. Aren't you at least a little sorry to see it go?
Ain't going nowhere. I just don't buy it.
Oh, you
did. Just made a deal with Mr. Rat Mitchell at the car place.
Well, how much?
Oh, that's between me and him.
For God's sake, why didn't you just buy it for Mama? You just saved money.
Your mama ain't nothing but business as it is. You ain't gonna make no monthly car payments to her. Does he mind the regular way?
Well, it's a good car, all right. I guess nobody knows that better than you.
best one off the line. And this new one, this Daisy don't take to it, I let her ride it this year now and again.
Mighty kind of you.
Well, we are doing what we can. Hey, watch them apps you found my pulse.
We We were at a picnic somewhere. Someone must have taken us bathing. And I asked Papa if I could dip my hand into the water. And he laughed. Oh, I was so timid then. And then I tasted that salt water on my finger. Isn't it silly to remember that?
No sillier than what most folks remember. You talking about the first time? I haven't had to tell you about the first time I leave the state of Georgia.
Where was that?
About 25 minutes back. My daughter married a pool importer on the Ensign, and she's always going to see New York, St. Louis, Detroit, talking about snorkeling waves and riding in subway cars. And I thought that's pretty nice, Tommy, but I just don't see the need. So I gotta tell you, Miss Daisy, Alabama ain't looking like much so far.
Well, it's nicer on the other side of Montgomery.
If you say so. Hey, pass me those peaches, please, ma'am.
Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
That sign, it's at Phoenix City, 30 miles. We're not supposed to go to Phoenix City. Oh, my God.
Maybe you done read it wrong.
I didn't. Stop the car. Stop the car. Here. You took the wrong turn at Opelika.
You took it with me, and you're reading the map. It'd be more than 30 minutes since we made that turn, Miss Daisy.
Oh, I am such a fool. I shouldn't have come by myself with just you in the car. Holy Mary. Should have come on the train. I'd be safe there. I just should have come on the train.
Yes, sir. You should have.
St. Clair Harris.
My cousin, St. Clair?
His wife.
Jeanette?
The one talk funny?
Well, she's from Canton, Ohio.
She tried to hire me.
What?
She called the home, the house, and Miss Daisy's up. She goes, how they treating you there, Hope? Mm. You know how she talks with her nose all stuffed up like that. I said, fine. As she said, well, if you're ever looking for a change, you know where to call.
Well, I'll be damned.
I thought you wanted to know about that.
I'll be goddamn.
Ain't she a mess? She said, name your salary. Coffee here since Adela passed.
Y'all right? I can fix the biscuits and you can fry a chicken, but nobody can make Adela's coffee. Wonder how she did it.
I don't know. Every time I see the hip parade come on TV, it put me in mind of Adela.
Yes.
Sitting in that chair, her daughter said, like surprise of flowers in springtime, watching the hip parade every Saturday looks set. During the Lucky Strike Extra, all of a sudden, she belched and she gone.
Adela was lucky.
I expect she was.
Where are you going?
Put this here up and take off my overshoes.
didn't have to come today, Hope.
What are you talking about, Miss Daisy? Ain't my day off today, is it?
Well, I don't know what you can do around here except keep me company.
I'd see if I light us a fire.
Well, eat anything you want in the icebox.
Yes, sir.
It's all gonna spoil anyway.
Miss Daisy, what do you think I am? A mess?
Yeah, that's exactly what I think you are.
All right.
Hello?
It'll all be cleared up by this afternoon. Said so on the radio. As soon as I can get down the drive, I'll come get you, okay?
Stay where you are, Booley. Hulk is here with me.
Hulk? How the hell did he manage that?
He's very handy. I'm fine. I don't need a thing in the world.
Well, hello. Do I have the right number? I have never heard you say something loving about Hope before.
I didn't say I loved him. I said he was handy.
Uh-huh.
Are you trying to irritate your mother during an ice storm?
Stop talking to me.
thank you, Red. Thank you all. I am deep and grateful to be named Man of the Year by the Atlanta Business Association. This is an honor I've seen bestowed upon some mighty fine fellows, and one I never thought would come to me. I'm afraid the loss up here and the gain here have given me an air of competency I don't possess. But I tell you, I sure wish my father and my grandfather could be here to see this today. 72 years ago, they opened a little hole-in-the-wall shop on Whitehall Street with one printing press, and they managed to grow with Atlanta. And today, the Worthing Company believes that we want what Atlanta wants. And this award proves we must be right. Thank you. Oh, one more thing. If the dogs whoop the jackets up in Athens on Saturday afternoon, I will be a completely happy man. Thank you. Thank you.
Feasibility of this.
Fine, you drive. I was just trying to be helpful.
Now, you know, I think Martin Luther King's done some mighty fine things.
Bully, if you don't want to go, why don't you just come right out and say so?
No, I want to go.
Florine.
Now, you just leave Florine out of this. I still have to conduct business in this town, you know?
I see. The Worthing Company will go out of business if you go to the King dinner?
Not exactly. But a lot of the men I do business with, Mama won't like it. They never say so. They just snicker and call me Martin Luther Worthing or something. And then, Mama, I've noticed that our banking business wasn't being handled by the top dogs anymore. Then I miss a special favor or two. Few tips. Not get that invitation to the luncheon at the Commerce Club. Little things, Mama, you can't quite put your finger on. And then Jack Raphael over at Ideal Press, well, he's a New York Jew instead of a Georgia Jew. And if they got a deal with Jews, the really good ones come from New York, don't they? So suddenly the boys start sending their business to old Jack instead of Martin Luther Wood. Maybe it wouldn't happen, Mama, but that's the way it works. Look, if we don't use those seeds, somebody else will, right? The good Dr. King would never know the difference, would he?
If we don't use the seeds, you mean I'm not supposed to go either?
Mama, you can do whatever you want.
Well, thanks for your permission.
Can I ask you something? When did you get so fired up about Martin Luther King anyway? Time was, I'd have heard a different story.
Why, Booley, I have never been prejudiced, and you know.
Okay, then why don't you ask Hope to go with you?
Hope? Well, don't be ridiculous. Hope would go.
Ask him, Mama, and see.
Myself.
Hello,
Mr. Worthen.
Oh, how are you this morning?
I'm horrible, Mr. Worthen.
What can I do for you this morning?
It's your mama.
What's the matter with her?
She's worked up.
Why should today be different from any other day?
No, this ain't the same.
Oh!
Yes, sir? She thinks she's teaching. I'm a bit worried about her. She ain't making no sense.
I'll be right there.
Yes, sir?
Oh, where'd you put my papers?
There ain't no papers, Miss Daisy.
My papers? I corrected them all last night and I put them right out in front so I wouldn't forget them on the way to school. Where'd you put them?
You took it out of your head.
Oh, my children would be so disappointed if I don't give them their homework back. I always give it back to them the next day. That's why they like me. Why aren't you helping me?
What do you want me to do?
Give me my papers, I told you. It's all right if you're moving. I won't be mad. But I gotta get to school now. I'll be late. And who'll take care of my place? They'll be alone. Oh, God. Oh, God, I do everything wrong.
From when I first came here, Miss Daisy? Go on, Miss Daisy. That thing in the junkyard 50 years now. I'm driving next to last car. 63 Cadillac. Trying to find us why.
You shouldn't be driving anything the way you see.
How do you know the way I see unless you're looking out of my eyes? Yes.
You're my best friend.
Come on, Daisy.
No, really. You are. You are.
Morning, Mr. Worth.
Oh, you didn't drive yourself out here?
Nah, it's my granddaughter. run me out.
Was she old enough to drive?
Michelle, 37. Teaches biology at Spelman College.
I never knew that.
Yes, yes.
I've taken everything I want out of the house. Is there anything you want before the goodwill comes?
No, my face will be bursting now.
Seems funny to sell the house while I'm still alive.
I agree.
But she hasn't been in the doors for 2 years. I think I'm doing the right thing.
Don't get me into that.
I'm not going to say anything to her about this.
You're right about that.
By the way, Hope, your check is going to keep coming every week as long as you're there to get it.
I appreciate that, Mr. Ward.
You can rest easy on it. I don't suppose you get out to see Mama very much.
No, it's part of driving it. That place ain't on no bus line. I take a taxi cab sometimes.
Well, I'm sure she appreciates it.
Sometimes she's better than other days. Look away.
Well, I suppose we better get on out there, huh? You've got a turkey dinner to get to, and so do I. Hey, why don't we just call up your granddaughter, tell her I'll run you home.
Every week.
Hell,
here. He didn't even touch a Thanksgiving pie. Let me help you with that.